right, the airplane gasoline inside of the car, but without the original jump, it still would not do any good.
所以呢，必须有一个电瓶去启动。所以呢，我们人也是一样，人在生命当中，在父母给予生命的时候，啊，它是有一个先天之气。Therefore,
if we really look at life itself, there must be also something that's already pre-existing. That's just like the electric, the initial starting, and that's called what? The prenatal chi, the prenatal energy. That's already given by the universe and also by our parents, right? When right, the fetus was created or formed.
所以呢，这是先天，还有一个。So
that's the definition for what? The first kind of chi, prenatal chi. Now the second definition for the postnatal chi, the postnatal.
后天之气呢，就是我们吃的饮食。
喝的水, is from the drinks, right?
然后呼吸的空气, 经过体内硬化, 产生了一种精微的这个气, 也叫,
After everything gets processed by the body,
提炼的, 所以说呢, 这个就是后天之气,
the refinement of this so-called prenatal energy is called prenatal energy.
如果只靠先天的气, 我们人并活不了多长时间。
So we cannot really survive just from the prenatal or the universal.
就像我们不要用 gas， 只要用电瓶发动起来以后开车出去，所以你这个卡 car 呢，可能也就跑不了多远，就靠嘟。
Just like the car, you know, if we don't add the later postnatal gasoline, right? If we just depend on the original electric, right? Very soon, right? The battery will die.
所以呢，它实际是把它去点燃以后。
So really, it's just a starting. It's just something to tap in. Once you tap in, then another system of energy takes over. He's talking about the training and the energy.
对，这就是心意。涉及到心意道的时候，要会讲到这些东西。涉及到心意拳，是吧？涉及到内功拳，涉及到养生，涉及到。 这些修炼的东西和这些是离不开，这里边就有一个丹田的问题。
So now we talk about 丹田 or so-called the field of what elixir. So because in terms of transformation or internal martial art or meditation, all has this two systems, right?
气的
prenatal chi and the postnatal chi. So that's two different kind of chi.
对。所以呢，我刚才说的像这个，我查了一下，是吧？ 这婴儿的时候，就是从真正可以称之为胎儿的，到第九周的时候，啊，就出现了各种雏形。但是呢，从一开始，啊，从第二周开始就发现了心跳，啊，说明这个产生，啊，这个产生的这种跳，这种心，是吧？怎么来的，啊？所以说它。 是先天固有的东西，就是这种精微的东西，男精女精，是吧？构成产生生命的时候，这种心微，这种能够动的东西，能够有气的这个东西，这是一个先天的东西。这个东西呢，我想，是非常生命的，而且非常值得去研究的东西，是吧？这也就是我们行义道或者内修的人要特别。 注意修炼，特别注意寻找，特别注意研究，包括用现代的一些医学科学，怎么去共同去把它更好的开发，是吧？研究，是吧？为这个人类、为社会更好的去服务，是吧？So
I guided
一个人体科学的一门学科。So
after I did the research, I actually did some research in terms of the what I shared with everyone, the 9 weeks, right? Why 9 weeks? Because when we talk about the pregnancy. The pregnancy actually is really official pregnancy in terms of performing the shape. Actually starts from the 9th week. Before the 9th week, it was what? Remember we talked about the 2nd week? Then there's some kind of right universal shock. From that universal shock, or that the energy, right? That energy came from the sperm and the egg. However, that formed some kind of mysterious pulsation, right? In terms of the prenatal heart, later, right, forming the heartbeat. That's very miraculous, and that's something the science is still, right, working on to discover, and that's the core of all the internal transformation energy systems, and that's very interesting as a, just as a deep science, as a inner discovery science.
Okay.
Now we talk about the intent, or the usage of the mind, or use of the heart, which is the mind. So heart, mind. Now we talk about the usage, intent.
意呢，我们从那个字义上，从简单的现在的理解上，意就是一种意念、意识，是吧？大脑的一种思维，是吧？产生于人的这大脑啊，中枢神经的这些一个活动。Well,
if we just again just look at the character itself, it's just really a movement of the brain, right? The movement from the central nervous system, or the right, the it's just a movement of the, you know, very, yeah, very straight.
Yeah, 但是在武术前辈和前人修炼过程，他们认为什么呢？意呢是大脑，它是通归于这个心的，由心来统，是吧？心来统领它，是吧？心动，是产生了意。
However, the subtle discovery, the subtle observation from the internal martial art masters are that the intent, even though blah blah, we talk about the brain and all that, right? But the intent is actually an energy vibration, almost an energy movement from the original what? The consciousness, the heart. So there's a very specific way to observe those two relationships and to actually discover further more inner connections.
对吧？所以在练功，在武术形意里边，它叫什么呢？心为元帅，啊，意为什么号令，这发号这个命令，是吧？意为号令，是吧？气为先锋。So
like just like almost like in a war, okay? So the ancient writings of this internal martial arts, what the consciousness, the right, the general, right, and then the commander. Then there's a general gives another commander. The commander is your intent, and then the chi, your energy, becomes the soldier, the frontal soldier. So there's three steps.
Qi为先锋，静和动作为这个士兵，为作战的士兵。
And then the movement, right? So now, right, the frontal commander, right? Frontal soldier, and then the later soldier are what? Your movement. So your movement, right, are actually the force, right? The force derivative of the original, right, commander.
在练功的时候呢，又讲什么呢？为了达到这种很好的这个预防、很好的攻击，一个完整的系统，它往往又讲六合。
Now to be more specific, right? To make the attack and also defense a perfect, right, complete system, we talk about the six harmonies. Again, three pairs of inner connections, or six pairs.
他讲的是形与意合。
First one is what? The right, the mind harmony with the intent. The heart and the intent. Prenatal mind and the postnatal mind. That's the first one.
意与气合。
The intent harmonizes with your energy, your qi.
气与力合。
And then the qi, the energy, in harmony with your power.
这样的是内在。
So that's the first three.
外在的呢，他就要讲什么呢？ 肩和胯合,
so that's the first three internal.
肘和膝合,
in terms of the three external, right, the shoulder, right, harmony with the pelvic, okay, the elbow, harmony with your knee.
手和脚合,
and then the hand harmonize with your feet.
所以呢，在这个我们如果看一个好的，如果我们看 MMA 看这个kickboxing 或者是在这个搏斗等，你就可以看到，是吧？恰恰这动作的协调性几个相合的很好。 他这个运动员就很容易把对方给战胜，是吧？他就会技术发挥得很好。
We can see this reflected in any even modern competitive sport like MMA or kickboxing, right? As long as we say this one athlete or this one competitor is highly what? Coordinated. When we talk about coordinated, right? The winner usually is the one that's more coordinated, and that's what we're talking about, right? Those inner combinations.
所以呢，这就是内行看门道，看门道；外行看热闹，是吧？所以呢，它也有一个 对这个技术的衡量的一个标准。
Therefore, you know, the people who really are in the profession really don't really look for just for fun. We actually look for a certain standard to evaluate, right? What is the right higher level or lower level in terms of this right profession?
对，所以呢，刚才我说了先啊，又讲的简单，讲的易。
So we briefly went over the consciousness and also the intent.
所以呢，心呢就是一个。心一动就产生了意。
So when the movement of the consciousness will give birth to intent.
哦，但是这个呢，我们很理解，容易理解。心，对，肯定是意念是通过心在想在那。但是这个环节怎么去完成，怎么去找到？所以呢，用话，我们看书或者是讲很简单啊，师父这么讲了。徒弟也这么说了，书上这么写了，我们看的也是这样。但是你真正在练功当中找到了你的心，找到了你的意，就不是那么容易了。
But remember we talk about the subtle connection, right? The subtle observation, right? To see how exactly that an energy momentum happened, right? Between the consciousness and then the separate intent, right? That's easy to say, and also that's easy to describe. But actually to feel it in actuality,to make the actual, right, actualize the experience in your being through the practice of martial art, that's not easy.
所以呢，传统练功修炼功夫、修炼内家、修炼心理的功夫的人，啊，他一直通过修炼以后，他把这个心，啊，就是心是一个本能的东西，心为心有一种本体又是本能的东西，这种本能的东西呢。啊，它不是我们想制造或者想那个什么就，它就天生就有的这有一个东西。这个东西怎么来的？是吧？是上天也好，是上帝也好，是或宇宙也好，或者是，哎，它就有这么一个东西。
This Xin, right? That's what every you know spiritual lineage talk about. This heart is really this inherent energy that's beyond the creation or destruction, right? That's something that every single human being is born with. But it's really, there's a way, right? There's a specific way to train and also to tap in and also to actualize and to utilize it. And that's what our system is about.
所以呢，练功一定要先真正的通过修炼以后，把它在自我能够有一个明确的一个感受。
So the real, I mean, what is really practice for after all this, right? The practice is really to make that, again, what we talked about, that discovery of that heart, that consciousness into an actualization in, as an individual being. That's how
we're doing. 不是我们简单的 sports, 我们
just not just like a simple sport.
打球也好，是打圈也好，
right.
我们肢体上的动作都好办，但是呢，如果能真正发挥它的作用，产生它的能量，这个时候。就不是我们简单能训练能够一般的这种体育锻炼能够找到的东西。
But to have that inner discovery, right? To have that inner discovery of all the deep, right? The in-depth master, right? Where that heart is, that cannot be reached by some simple just movement. That takes some, right? Quite meditative work.
所以呢，完整的前辈的一句话叫心。为先天之本能。
So now let's categorize it, okay? The heart is the original function, the basic instinct, or the basic ability of the prenatal dimension, prenatal dimension.
这种先天呢，不是你自己那个什么的，就是说。
That prenatal dimension is not an individual thing. It's not your.
就是
but it's consciousness.
这个一个生命在父母是吧精卵产生，这也是从先天开始，是吧？这也是，
so,
就是本身之前就会有的。
Right,
所以理解的我们能理解到这一步，再往深理解呢，能不能追溯上去呢？所以呢，也是修炼的一直在，能不能形成天人合一？能不能形成由我，是吧？由你的本体来感受到。
To actually reach that level, right, of the force, the original force behind all force, right, even the force behind the meeting, the giving energy from the sperm and the egg, even the universal energy behind that, that will determine whether a practitioner will actually be able to attain the so-called original nature, right? The original face, or the harmony between the small self and also the universe.
意是由心一动而产生的，啊，由心动产生的意，心不动，啊，修炼的时候一定要把心止下去，一动不了的时候就出不来。And
then to actually observe the relationship between the thoughts, right, or the intent, is that once you really, really learn how to quiet the mind and also quiet the consciousness to a certain level and certain depths, then you understand the second part of the writing. Intent is actually what? Is a function of the postnatal dimension, a later dimension, a postnatal dimension. Well, the heart is a
original. So, it is after the action. 要反向先天。
Now, okay, now, look, now it's reverse.
作用于先天。
Now we're going to talk about reverse. Why do we have to discover all this? Well, remember, the heart is very hard to find, right? It's original, it's beyond the concept of mind. But the intent is postnatal, it's able to locate. But now, what we're going to do is that we're going to using the method of locating the what? Using the intent, using the postnatal mind to what? To trace back to the master. To the original resource of initial movement. So that's the whole idea.
So this heart, it's a natural thing, right? It's got energy, it's got instinct, it's got ability, right? To use intent to create unlimited energy flow, or special energy flow. 是吧？产生的功夫上超人的能量，超人的本事，是吧？体现在外边，是吧？他就比一个人很强多少。有的人个子很小，一个很体重大的人，照样被他给那个什么掉。就是这是一个非简单的非常，但是他的这个能量，我只是指的我们眼睛看到的、看不到的更产生特异的能量的东西，是吧？ 也是有的，是吧？这个东西呢，就是说，这就是这个反这个道，这一条路，这就是道。So
again, once now we're only using a very small part, right? We're segregated into the intent. But now once we use this whole principle, using the intent to trace back to the original heart or the original source of energy, then we will be applying the energy and the supernatural, we can even say, or superhuman power, like even in martial art, or even certain higher dimensions of invisible power, from the original source, which is the heart, the original right field, or whatever infinity itself. This whole path is called Da, the Da.
所以呢，这就是我们现在刚才提到的行义道。
So that's why, that's where the name came from. So we just spent that time to describe the formation of that name, Xinyi-Dao. So the path of using the what? Intent to trace back to the original heart. So that's the definition of Xinyi-Dao.
Okay. Xinyi-Dao, 我这里呢，所以刚才讲了半天以后，我这里呢就有一个简单的概念，是吧？用几句话可以概括。
So now I can categorize the whole thing.
就是心为意之体。
So the heart is the original body of the heart is the original body, the master of the intent.
意为心之用,
but the intent is the usage of the functioning of the heart.
心发动而产生了意,
the initiate the heart and then the intent is formed.
意所向, 意表达的所向出来, 在这个修炼的这个当中就为全。
Okay.
我意念在练的时候，我意念要出来。 出来动作，这时候产生了一个圈，就出来了。
Now the intent, remember this intent we're talking about what? The connected with the original heart intent. This intent manifests into different shapes and into different movements. Then that kind of intent-based movement That's why it's called a meditative, right, movement. It's called the art of the fist or kung fu.
对，在研究这个时候呢，拳道如一，是吧？
Therefore, we call the quan the fist, and also the dao is one.
对
，right? The movement dao is one.
我们去少林寺的时候，到中国嵩山少林寺，一进了他的大门以后，你就会看到立了一个碑，他那边写的是参拳如一。So
when you first walk in Shaolin Temple, which again I mean he's a head coach in the 90s of the Shaolin Temple. Once you go in there, and then you will see a whole writing, right? So it says Zen and the fist as one. Zen and the fist as one. But this fist is not this fist. Fist is the art, meditative movement.
对，所以呢，这个圈呢，就是现代中国武术讲的武术，现代英语讲的 martial arts 都是这个圈。
So this quan or fist is really the another name for kung fu or martial arts.
啊，在修炼这个圈。 它也是一个修道的一条船，啊，一个路。
It is another mean. It is another vehicle toward enlightenment, toward searching for the whole, the completeness.
佛教的时候呢，把这个圈呢，也是一条路，是吧？它有好多法门，是吧？其中，少林用拳来走的一条法门，佛教的这条法门。所以
spirituality has so many different. Means to the end, right? Many multiple means, method, and the martial art is only one of the method to attain enlightenment.
所以呢，就是这个道，我们就心通过心通过意来产生拳。这个拳呢，在修道，所以呢，我刚才这个概念就出来了，这就是行一道。So
that's again, you know, they just categorize. We just abbreviated everything, right?
啊，行一道呢
right, move. To the back to the
圈和道是一个方向在做，但是呢，为什么要特意要现在我说是道呢？实际呢，就是说这个从道的角度来讲，我们现代社会在冷兵器阶段的时候，没有枪的时候，没有炮的时候，没有原子弹的时候，是吧？没有飞机的时候，是吧？人类。 不管是这个战争也好，不管是统治者也好，不管是人类生存也好，都要去练拳，是吧？练武，练 martial arts 来保卫自己，是吧？战胜一个国家也是要靠这些东西，都是拿着长矛、盾牌什么的，是吧？到了现代社会，是吧？热兵器阶段都有了，是吧？